In this problem, let us start from what is cot theta minus tan theta, which gives you, I'm converting tan and cot in terms of sine and cos, so we are going to get so if I take the LCM, so in the numerator we are getting cos square theta minus sine square theta, which is nothing but your cos 2 theta. And if I multiply 2 in the numerator and denominator, so we are going to get 2 cot 2 theta. Is it clear to all of you? Have you understood this? Now you see, we are getting cot theta equals to tan theta plus 2 cot 2 theta, right? Now again, cot 2 theta, similarly, we can prove that this is nothing but tan 2 theta plus 2 cot 2 square theta. Is it clear? So what we are getting? Tan theta plus 2 tan 2 theta plus 2 square cot 2 square theta. Is it clear? Now, again, cot 2 square theta can be similarly can be replaced by tan 2 square theta plus cot 2 cube theta. Is it clear? Now, if I open the bracket, we are going to get tan theta plus 2 tan 2 theta plus 2 square tan 2 square theta plus, I'm sorry, a 2 will be there, 2 cube cot 2 cube theta. Is it clear? And this is exactly what they have given us to prove. Have you understood this problem? Now, one thing you must remember, for MCQ, you please remember these result as a formula. Why I'm telling you? Because a lot of questions can come where you can directly replace by this, by this expression with cot theta. And one thing you remember, generalizing it. Tan theta plus 2 tan 2 theta plus 2 square tan 2 square theta. You go on like this. Again, 2 cube tan 2 cube theta. And this thing goes on. Okay? Now, if you want to end, anywhere if you want to end, let's say, let me just end at 2 to the power n. So, it will be 2 to the power n cot 2 to the power n theta. Okay? How many number of terms you want to write, that is your choice. You write down. But you end with cot theta. Okay, and the answer will be always equals to cot theta for this kind of sums. Is it clear? That is why I told you, please remember this sum, the result as a formula. Is it clear to all of you? Now here I want to discuss about the sum of sine and cos series. Say the series is something like this, sine alpha plus sine, alpha plus beta, sine alpha plus 2 beta, and this thing goes on till n terms, sine alpha plus n minus 1 into beta. Okay? Similarly, we are writing the cos series, cos alpha plus beta, cos alpha plus 2 beta. This thing goes on till n terms. It will be cos alpha plus n minus 1 into beta. Okay? Now, these are the two formulae that I will give you. I will suggest all the students to remember these two formulae. Okay? Because maximum case in trigonometry, while you will do sums, you will face, you know, this kind of series in your problem. So there you can directly use the formula to get your answer. It's a very, very important two formulae. For the first one, always remember, and I'm telling you how to remember the formula also. You write, this is sine alpha plus beta, and this is the sine series, this is the cos series. So you will write sine n beta by 2 divided by sine beta by 2. This is always fixed. In this case also you will write sine n beta by 2 by sine beta by 2. Can you remember this part? Okay. Now for this one, what we will do, since it's a sine series, you will write sine first angle plus the last angle divided by 2. Is it clear? So for this one, what you will write? For this part I'm writing, it will be, this part will be your sine. In this case, the first angle is alpha. The last angle is alpha plus n minus 1 into beta. So it will be sine alpha plus n minus 1 into beta by 2. Is it clear? Similarly, you come for the cos one. Same thing, cos the first angle plus the last angle divided by 2. Again, I'm writing this part as, you see, cos, the first angle is alpha, the last angle is alpha plus n minus 1 into beta. So your answer will be alpha plus n minus 1 into beta by 2. Is it clear? So you have to remember these two formulae by heart. Okay. Now let us just move for some, I will just show you some problems which will illustrate this two formulae elaborately. For the illustration purpose of this sine and cosine series formula, we have taken a very simple sum, and in cos series, which is cos pi by 11, cos 3 pi by 11, cos 5 pi by 11, plus cos 7 pi by 11, plus cos 9 pi by 11, we have to evaluate its value. Now here I will show you how to apply the cosine series formula. Let us take pi by 11 as your alpha. So the expression becomes okay. Now we can write this thing as cos 3 alpha. I'm writing it as cos alpha plus cos alpha plus 2 alpha. Cos 5 alpha, I'm writing it as cos 7 alpha, I'm writing it as and cos 9 alpha, I'm writing it as. Is it clear? So in this case, your beta is nothing but 2 alpha. And in this case, your number of terms is 5. So n is 5 and beta is nothing but 2 alpha. So according to our cosine series formula, we can write this thing as sine n beta by 2, n beta by 2 divided by sine beta by 2. Okay, then cos the first angle plus the last angle divided by 2, which gives you sine 5 alpha by 2 cos, I'm sorry, it's only 5 alpha, sine 5 alpha, cos 5 alpha, cos 5 alpha divided by sine alpha. Now if I multiply 2 with numerator and denominator, we are going to get in the numerator as sine 10 alpha, and in the denominator we are getting 2 sine alpha. Is it clear? Now 10 alpha can be replaced by, look it carefully, pi minus alpha is nothing but your 10 alpha. So in this case it will be sine pi minus alpha divided by 2 sine alpha. Sine 180 minus theta will give you sine theta. So sine alpha divided by 2 sine alpha. Sine alpha goes off. So your answer is half. This is how we apply the summation of cosine series. Is it clear to all of you? Similarly, you can apply, if you have understood this, then you can easily apply the formula for the sine series also. Is it clear to everybody? Have you understood this clearly?